In this lesson, we will look at types of key. In the last few lessons, we've learnt about several types of key. We've learnt about a primary key, which is a field in a table which is unique and allows you to identify every record in the table. We've learnt about a foreign key that we use to link entities or tables together and create a relationship. The field is in one table is linked to the primary key in another table. And we've also learnt what a compound or composite key is, which combines more than one field to make a unique value. There are other types of keys that we need to learn for this controlled assessment. First of all, we need to learn what a surrogate key is. Sometimes you need to create a linked table to resolve an ERD many-to-many. Instead of using a compound key, you can create a new primary key to link them. This is called a surrogate key. The sole purpose of it is to create the new primary key link on the many-to-many. Another type of key that you could use is something called a secondary key. This is a key that's used for indexing data. This means it can sort data in a different order to the primary key. We can use any of the field names in any of the tables to create one, but we would call this a secondary key. It is also important in our database that we maintain what we call integrity. This means that we make sure that the data in there is accurate and maintained. We don't want, obviously, in a database any records to be lost or deleted, so we use database integrity to make sure that this does not happen. There are several ways we can make sure that data is not lost. First of all, we can use physical integrity. This is a simple thing that you would do perhaps on your coursework, which means you check files are protected and backed up. The second way we can protect data is use something called an entity integrity. This ensures that records in a table always have a primary key, so they can always be separated from another entity or record in the table. The final thing we're going to come on to is something called referential integrity. This means that there is always a related record in the table with the one part of the relationship. So for example, an order must always have a customer, as it cannot exist without one. If the customer was deleted from the database, you would need to delete the order because the customer would no longer be there. Here is a worked example. If you look at the paint shop example, it's possible to have a supplier in the database who did not supply the company with paints. They may have done so in the past, but they do not stock any of their paints now. However, it is impossible to have paints in the database which do not have any supplier. Referential integrity exists to make sure that it's impossible to enter a reference to a link which does not exist. Please have a good thorough look at the diagram so you can see how this works. It is quite easy to enforce referential integrity, and indeed you may have already seen this on the examples that we have done. To find the referential integrity, you first need to go into relationships. Once you have done this, you need to make sure you have the right relationship, for example, one to many, and check that everything is correct in the above box, the ones you want to link to. Check your relationship type here to make sure that you have the right relationship type and you've not linked it to the wrong field heading. And then if you click reinforce referential integrity, this will ensure that nothing can be deleted that shouldn't be deleted without the record in the other table being deleted at the same time. You may also want to do something called cascade upgrade related fields or cascade delete related fields. For relationships that reinforce referential integrity between tables, the updating of all records in the related table or tables when the record in the primary key is changed, and cascade delete for relationships that enforce referential integrity between tables, the deletion of all records in the related table when the record in the primary table is deleted. If you set these options, delete and update operations would normally be prevented by referential integrity rules are allowed. When you delete records or change the primary key, one or more fields whose values uniquely identify each record in the table. A primary key cannot allow null values and so must always have a unique index. A primary key is used to create a table to other foreign keys in other tables. Values in a primary table. A primary table should always have a primary key and each record should be unique. Microsoft Access makes necessary changes to related tables to preserve referential integrity. So, if you select the cascade update related fields checkbox when defining a relationship, any time you change the primary key of a record in the primary table, Microsoft Access automatically updates the primary key to a new value in all related records. For example, if you change a customer's ID in the customers table, the customer ID field in the orders table is automatically updated for every one of the customer's orders, so the relationship isn't broken. Microsoft Access cascades updates without displaying any message. However, if you select the cascade delete records box when defining a relationship, then any time you define or delete records in the primary table, Microsoft Access automatically deletes related records in the related table. For example, if you delete a customer record from the customers table, all customers' orders are automatically deleted from the orders table. This includes records in the order details table related to the order records. When you delete records from a form or a data sheet with the cascade deleted records checkbox selected, Microsoft Access warns you that related records may also be deleted. However, when you delete records using the delete query, which we will learn later on, that removes rows matching the criteria you specify from one or more tables, Microsoft Access will automatically delete these in related tables without displaying a warning. So just be aware of this when we learn this later.